Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. There's a handful of updates to cover today for the standard SpaceX updates. Then we have a few Boca Chica updates as well as some Starship with a load of SN8. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As you know, SpaceX launched the Starlink 13 mission on Sunday whilst I was producing my video. Booster B1051 lifted off for the sixth time.
Ignition and lift off.
This booster, which is the second to have lifted off six times, then performed a flawless landing on the Of Course I Still Love You drone ship.
And right down the middle, Falcon 9 has landed. This particular booster has landed for the sixth time. This marks our 62nd successful recovery of a Falcon 9 first stage, and the 32nd time we've landed on this particular drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You.
They also showed a brief clip in the live stream of a fairing half in a net, but it didn't look entirely nominal. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 14 launch has been delayed, looking like it could lift off tomorrow now. There's a new article posted by Space Coast Daily about an interesting payload SpaceX will be launching. Aboard the CRS-21 mission, set to launch in a matter of months, will be a new type of airlock created by a company called NanoRacks. Apparently, the airlock will provide payload hosting, robotics testing and satellite deployment, and will also serve as an outside toolbox for crew members conducting spacewalks. Microsoft have been working with SpaceX and will partner up to connect their Azure network to the Starlink constellation. Now, looking over in Boca Chica, SpaceX are working on building a new orbital launch mount. Recently, they've been doing a whole load of groundwork nearby, which you can see is coming along nicely. There's an interesting new addition to the launch site. Apparently, this is a long-range acoustic device. Also, looks like there is indeed a new tent going up at the new orbital pad area. There's also concrete work that has been going on in front of the new bunker structures. Looking at the high bay, which is being built for super heavy stacking, the back and the other side have been done for a while now. They are getting closer to completing this side as well. The new crane, dubbed Tankzilla, was prepared to be moved to the launch area for nose cone stacking. In terms of Starship, some new bulkheads were captured being worked on in a tent. Looks like they are currently constructing a new common dome, and you can see a lower bulkhead in the works. Inside the nose cone tent is yet another nose under construction. Could this potentially be for SN9? Something interesting spotted were engineers painting the older fairing section white. People have suggested maybe as a mock-up for the lunar Starship variant. In response to a tweet from Everyday Astronaut, Musk tweeted about some Raptor information. He said, "Raptor has now run for 90 seconds at 300 bar chamber pressure before encountering issues. 210 metric ton sea level operating thrust seems achievable with no major changes. Our boost variant is aiming for 300 ton thrust at 300 bar with same nozzle exit area. We'll need bigger pumps." Then he responded with, "Got a little melty to be honest." Asked about the Raptors on SN8, Musk responded with, "Those engines could go 300 bar but would be dicey. Pushing it for near-term tests doesn't achieve anything, but I'm confident Raptor will do 300 bar for orbital flights." Moving on to the star of the show at the moment, we have the serial number 8 Starship. Before we take a look at testing, here we have the nose cone and it was prepared for stacking to form a fairing. Something interesting to show attached to this nose is a counterweight. After the nose was moved out of the windbreaker, the ring stacked to support it was moved in its place. Next, the nose cone was hooked up to a crane in order to be lifted and stacked with the barrel section. And finally, they lifted it and moved it over inside the windbreaker, then later stacked these two. Here's a quick shot of that beautiful new fairing section. With the nose being prepared in the yard, over at the launch area is the rest of SN8. Engineers continued to work on it on Sunday in preparation for what we were expecting to be a static fire. During their testing window on Monday morning, the company started getting ready as activity picked up. A little later on, they looked to have attempted a test, but that was aborted. Just after the end of the road closure, they were once again ready for the first test, which wasn't a static fire. Instead, they performed the first seemingly successful pre-burner test of all three Raptor engines. Early on Tuesday morning, during their next test window, they prepared to light the engines once again. This time, with no abort beforehand, they fired up just the pre-burners for a second test to make sure all is good. Finally, later into the morning, the SpaceX team geared up for the main event, a static fire. Then it happened, the first ever firing of three Raptor engines simultaneously. So cool to watch history in the making. Musk tweeted about the static fire and said, "Data from three engine Starship static fire this morning looks good, proceeding with nose cone mate." After that testing, SN8 was seen being worked on up top. Whilst I can't show it, SN8 also performed some more testing last night, but there was no engine firing. I also want to show the addition of some heat shield tiles to the body of SN8. Looking at the Cameron County road closures, we have something interesting we've not seen before. There is a date for today, earlier this morning between 7 a.m. and 12, then 3 to 5 p.m. and from 9 p.m. until 6 a.m. tomorrow. They also have another backup closure between 9 p.m. tomorrow and 6 a.m. Friday. With SN8 only just beginning to do epic stuff, we also have other starships in the works. On the left is the SN9 tank still getting readied for the flap installation, and next to it SN10 as the stacked section is worked on. Another starship in which sections have been seen under construction is SN11. SpaceX recently sleeved the upper bulkhead with the ring stack for the top of the methane tank. Along with the other sections, thanks to Brendan Lewis, we can see how the pieces of this starship are coming together. I can't finish my video without thanking Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, for her very long nights and dedication to filming the progress. Also, behind the scenes and doing fantastic live streams are the NASA spaceflight team, thank you all as well. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.